Good morning to all of you. Well, you braved the weather, and it's good to see you this morning. You know, we were kind of confused this morning whether or not to call services off, because when I got here, it wasn't sticking on the pavement, and after about 30 minutes, it started, so I thought, well, it's too late now. So anyway, it's good to see you today, and you know, the Bible says where two or three are gathered in His name, He's in our midst. So He's here this morning, amen? And we're glad that you're here, and pray the Lord will bless you during our time together this morning. We're going to the Annie Armstrong Easter offering. We're going to take it this morning, and we're also going to take it next Sunday. So just be mindful of that. We're going to do the two offerings. And again, it's good to see you. Did you know the sun is shining? We're just not high enough to see it. But it's out there, so it's a good day to be in the house of the Lord. I want to share some prayer requests with you at the close of the service. BJ is not here this morning, and that's one of the reasons why. It's not BJ, one of the family members. But let's go to the Lord in prayer and ask His blessing upon our time together today, okay? Father, we thank You for this day that You've blessed us with. And Lord, today we get to celebrate the Lord's Supper. Father, what a joy it is that we can come together as the people of God and, Lord, to celebrate what You have done for us. Lord, how can we say thanks for the things that You've done? How can we praise You enough because of Your love and sacrifice? Father, we thank You today. We love You. We lift up Your name. And Father, Your word says that You inhabit the praises of Your people. So Lord, may we praise You with all of our heart today. Father, thank You for what You'll do. In Jesus' name we pray, and for His sake, amen. We have a guest choir director this or worship leader this morning. She's a lot better looking than the last one, amen?
Good morning. If any of you have ever wanted to sing a solo, today is your chance. We're few in number, but our first hymn is 413, Break Thou the Bread of Life. We're singing verses 1, 2, 4, and 5.
Oh,
second hymn is 460, singing verses 1 through 3.
Thank you.
If you will, take your Bible and turn to the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter number 11. And I want to read a few verses before we partake of the Lord's Supper this morning. And what a joy and privilege it is to be able to come together as the church, as the body of Christ, enjoy communion together because of what the Lord Jesus Christ has done for us. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, beginning in verse number 23. I'm going to ask if you will please to stand for the reading of God's word. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus Christ, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and said, Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner, he also took the cup, and when he had supped, saying, This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do you as oft as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him drink and him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. Father, would you speak to us this morning? Lord, in our time together, Lord, I pray that you'll open this passage of Scripture to us, and that, Lord, we'll receive from you. In Jesus' name we pray, and for his sake, amen. When we come to this passage, Paul said he had received these things from the Lord Jesus Christ. And what he was speaking about was how the Lord's Supper was. If you would go back in time for just a moment, you would find that the Passover was something that was took place every year in the life of Israel. And during that time, they would take the Passover lamb, they would slay the lamb, then they'd go through all the rituals of the Passover lamb. Well, the Bible says as they were eating this Passover meal, Jesus institutes what we call the Lord's Supper. It's a change in everything they had been doing for hundreds and thousands of years, because now Jesus Christ himself would become the Passover lamb. No longer would it be the blood of bulls and calves, but now it would become the precious blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Jesus would give his life, his blood, his body on the cross so that you and I might have life and life everlasting. Before he went to the cross, he shared this with his disciples. And he said, whenever you partake of this, whenever you come together as a fellowship, whenever you partake of the Lord's Supper, you need to understand what is taking place and not to take it lightly. That's why Paul said in this passage, a person is supposed to examine himself. You say, well, what do you mean? Well, it says if you drink of it unworthily, you bring damnation or judgment to yourself. See, what was happening back then is they were getting together, they were having a meal, and the Lord's Supper became something that was just kind of tacked on. It became something that had lost its significance because there were partying and everything else. And Paul said, you need to understand the significance of the Lord's Supper. And he said, you're to eat of it worthily. So what did he mean worthily? What he was saying is, first of all, you have to be saved. You have to be saved to partake of the Lord's Supper because it means absolutely nothing to a lost person. But to the saved person, it means everything. And he says to us, you could be saved, but you're living in sin. You're not clean before God. That's what he was saying for those who were taken unworthily. He said, you need to examine yourself. Is there something between you and someone else? Is there something between you and God? And if there is, you need to deal with it. You need to confess it. Because if you confess your sins, the Bible says He's faithful and just to forgive you and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. In just a moment, as we take the Lord's Supper, remember what this means. The bread represents His body. His body that was broken for you. What does that mean? It means that He gave up His perfect body that God had given Him. He was a lamb without spot or blemish. But just like when Mary came and broke that alabaster box, the Bible says the Lord Jesus Christ was broken for you and me. He was broken. And then the cup represents the blood. The blood that takes away our sin. The blood that takes away our sin and makes us right with God. Because it is, as the book of Acts says, it was the very blood of God that makes us clean. So as we partake of the Lord's Supper this morning, remember, go back to the cross and remember the body that was given for you. Remember the blood that was shed on your behalf because of what Jesus has done. That's what the Lord's Supper is all about. And when we come together, we celebrate. We remember. We're thankful. We're grateful for what Jesus did on the cross. The very Lamb of God who gave Himself for you and I. Hallelujah. What a Savior we have. The Scripture says that as they were eating, that Jesus took bread and He blessed it. Brian, will you bless the bread, please?
Thank you.
as you eat the bread, remember the body that Jesus gave, sacrifice for you. Take and eat. The scripture says that after the bread, likewise he took the cup and he blessed it. J.R., will you bless the cup, please?
Almighty Heavenly Father, what a wonderful and precious service this is, where we come to remember you and your love for us, O Lord. Lord, this old feeble mind can hardly wrap around the love that you have for each one of us and for this world, Lord. We just thank you, Lord, for suffering and dying and shedding your precious blood to save sinners like us, Lord. Lord, your word tells us that without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin, Lord. So we thank you for your blood. We thank you for your body that you so willingly give for each and every one of us so that we may have entrance to thy holy kingdom. Lord, we love you, we praise you, we thank you, Lord, for it's in Jesus' name.
Represents the very precious blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. The blood that was shed for us to take away sin. The blood that was shed to appease the righteousness and holiness of God. Take and drink. The Lord's Supper is a very simple ceremony, but it means so much. Because we remember what Jesus has done for us. We remember the cross. We remember the fact that Jesus died on the cross for our sin. What a price he paid for you and I. And God was satisfied with his offering. That's how we have peace with God. The Bible says, having been justified by faith, we have peace with God. Isn't it amazing how the blood of Jesus can make us whole, can make us new? The Bible says, if any man is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. That's what Jesus did for you and I. And when you and I accept him, he comes into our lives and he changes us. He changes who we are. That's why we're a new creation. And that's why we rejoice. And that's why we come together on the Lord's Supper and we celebrate, because we remember how faithful Jesus was to us. Just a moment, we're going to have an invitation hymn. Maybe you're here this morning and you've never trusted him. You've never trusted him really as your Lord and Savior. Now, you may have said a few words. You may have joined a church. But if you look at your life, you could say, my life has really never changed. See, that's the difference when Jesus comes in. He changes you. He changes me. We are a new creation. That's the difference between having Jesus and having religion. It's not the same. Thank God for what Jesus has done for us. And maybe you just need to come this morning and say, I just want to follow him. Or maybe you've already made that decision, but you need to be baptized. You've trusted the Lord, but you haven't been baptized. You always put baptism on the right side of salvation. You said, what are you speaking of? Well, salvation comes first. You could have joined 5 churches, but never really were saved. It's only when you are saved that you're baptized, because baptism shows what you've already done, not vice versa. So maybe you need to come this morning as we stand and sing our invitation hymn. The Lord's speaking to you this morning. Would you step out and come? Let's stand together, please.
Our invitation hymn is 426, Blessed Be the Tie That Binds, singing all 3 verses.
Seth, come on up here, please, sir. This is Seth Haskell, and Seth has been saved. He is coming this morning for believer's baptism, join our fellowship. And we talked, what, 3 or 4 weeks ago, and he said, you know, he had played the game. And God just spoke to him, got his heart right with God, and now he's coming to celebrate what God's done in his life. So what a joy to watch this young man come and join us today. So do I hear a motion that we accept him as he comes this morning? There a second. If you're in favor, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. You know, God's been good to us lately, hasn't he? And you know what? It's as God's people pray and seek his face, God answers prayers, folks. So don't ever take lightly prayer, because prayer can do so many things. Seth, if you'll just, I'm going to be back at the back. If you'll just head that way, I'll be back there in just a moment, and the folks can greet you, because I need to make just a couple quick announcements. First of all, Doug Forney, recovering from spine surgery. So if you will pray for him. Also, they had to take Donnie Duvall back to the hospital last night, and Donnie is not doing good at all. Last I heard, trying to put a feeding tube in. Is that right, Butch? So please, please be in prayer for Donnie and Brenda, their family. And we've got John. Remember John? Remember Frank, Tony, Irene Baggerly. We've got several folks who are just very, very sick. Yeah, thank you, Charlie Howler. That's Janine's brother. I think he had an operation, but he coded last night. So that's why BJ's not here. So a lot of folks who are sick and really need our prayers. So please remember these as we pray. And it is so good to see you guys today. I know there's not a lot of you here, but that's okay. Amen?
Amen.
Have you had a good time in the Lord today? I hope you have, because it's a joy to be in the house of the Lord. Man, I'm glad to see Mr. Daniel back today. He's been off being the interim pastor over there in some old holler near us. And anyway, he's back today because they called off church. So my brother, why don't you lead us in prayer? Let's stand and we'll be dismissed, okay? Y'all come by and speak a word to Seth.
Symbolizes what you did for us, and what a wonderful thing that is. Lord, wrap your arms around those that need that special touch from you today. Lord, thank you for your work in this service this very day. And as we leave this place, may the worship within our hearts continue, even though we may leave the doors of the church building. Lord, we thank you for that. Keep us safe, keep us healthy, and bring us back to the next appointed time. I pray in Christ's name. Amen.